everybody. Welcome back to the Weekend Warrior Playbook. Dr. Justin Feldman from Feldman Physical Therapy and Performance. And this week, Dr. John Nunez is going to take us through the lunge, explain why it's important, how you can use it in your everyday life, and why mastering it is going to help you have fun on your weekend activities and stay pain-free.
Thanks, Justin. We're talking about these foundational movements, and the lunge is no different than the hip hinge or the squat. It's super important. Why? Because we spend so much of our life in this split stance, is what we like to call it, where one leg is forward, the other one is backwards. Whether you're walking, you spend half your time on one leg, or even our weekend warriors, when you run, it's just single leg hops. You're going from one leg to the next, one leg is going forward, the other one's going back. So why is this lunge so important? Well, first of all, it helps create better balance when we're doing activities, dynamic activities. So it gets all the muscle groups strengthened, especially those adductors, a really important stabilizing group for the lower leg. So in these split stance positions, the adductors can fire, make us stronger, and make our movements more efficient. Likewise, you can do a lot of different variations. You can do forward lunges, you can do backward lunges. We happen to like backward lunges for people who are novel to the movement or for people who might have knee pain. It changes the kinematics of the movement just a little bit, where we can still target what we need to target while keeping everybody safe. And injury prevention is, part of the name of the game. So we're going to go through a few variations of the lunges and how to execute it properly, and hopefully you can give it a try. All right, everybody, so now we're actually going to execute a lunge, and Justin's going to take us through. We'll start with a reverse lunge, like I mentioned before. So if everybody's following at home, go ahead and give it a try. So Justin's going to go ahead and drop back with one of his legs. And the important thing for the lunge now is that you always want to keep your front foot flat on the ground, okay? A lot of times we see people and they lift their heel off the ground and their weight comes forward. That's no good for a number of reasons. We want to keep the weight distributed mostly through the back two-thirds of your foot. If you can wiggle your toes a little bit, I think you're doing it right, but you definitely don't want to be too far forward and you don't want to be too far back on your heel either. So the idea is to be able to get almost a 90-degree angle, a front angle at the knee in the front, and then even with his torso and his front thigh. So keep good patterns, slow controlled motion, your back foot is on your toes, and you're just gonna slowly and control. That's the emphasis here. You don't wanna rush through it. Just try and drop your knee straight down to the ground. You don't wanna slam it on the ground, that'll hurt. So it's actually helpful to do this on maybe a harder surface, because it'll force you to slow it down and get more control. But Justin's keeping his torso nice and upright. Watch that front knee comes down to that 90-degree angle, and his foot's nice and flat. So this is a great execution of a reverse lunge. Go ahead and give it a try.
Thank you so much for tuning in to the Weekend Warrior Playbook. Dr. Justin Feldman from Feldman Physical Therapy and Performance, and that was the lunge. You're gonna find yourself in an uneven stance or a single leg stance many times throughout the day and through all of your weekend activities. So mastering the lunge will be key for pain-free movement and longevity in all of your activities. Make sure to tune in next week to the Weekend Warrior Playbook. We switch topics and we start talking about really easy exercises that nobody does, but that can make the biggest difference in your athletic performance.